let us discuss the phenomena of avalanche breakdown. Unlike to the situation of zener breakdown, for avalanche breakdown we can write that it occurs when P and N sides of a junction are moderately doped and depletion layer is thick. Say if we draw a situation like this in which P type and N type semiconductors in a junction are normally doped and the width of depletion layer is large. Say if this D is large, certainly in this situation on applying a reverse biasing voltage, if this P side, this N side, and we connect negative side of the battery to the P side of semiconductor and positive terminal of battery to the N side of semiconductor, and we close down the switch. In this reverse biasing, again an electric field is established in the junction from P side and N side, and again here the total field can be given as internal plus external field, and here external field is obviously due to the applied voltage. Now if we increase the voltage, then we can see in this situation the electric field will also increase, but compared to zener breakdown situation it will be relatively less because the width of this depletion layer is large. So here external electric field we can simply write V by D. So in this situation, due to this electric field, electrons from one side will start accelerating onto the other side. These will be having an acceleration given as EE by M, and as the width is large for the depletion zone, the electrons, these electrons which will accelerate through the depletion layer will attain high speeds when it will these electrons will reach the other terminal. And when these electrons from P side, which are actually the minority carriers of P side, will be accelerated to very high speed, and as width of depletion layer is large, in between if these electrons will collide with any of the electrons in the valence band of covalent bond of intrinsic semiconductor, these will attain so high energy that due to its collision, an electron hole pair is generated. And once electron hole pair is generated, these will start drifting in the opposite direction. So when some more electrons are produced in the conduction band, like if say an electron produces an electron hole pair in between the depletion layer, then the other produced electron will also oscillate and it may produce another electron hole pair in between. So the quantity of electrons and hole will suddenly multiply by many factor because each electron produces another electron, and other produced electron may also produce more electron hole pairs in the system. So suddenly numerous in quantity electrons and holes are generated in the depletion layer, and these will travel in opposite direction, and suddenly the overall current in the circuit will increase. This is the phenomena which we call avalanche breakdown phenomena. And if we talk about the breakdown voltage, then we can see that breakdown voltage for avalanche breakdown will always be more than breakdown voltage for zener breakdown, because in zener breakdown depletion layer is thin and breakdown take place at relatively low voltage because electric field at the same voltage will be excessively high. This is the way how we explain avalanche breakdown phenomena.